Welcome learners, this is the second video lecture on leadership. In my earlier video lecture, I have already discussed with you about the definition of leadership, its importance, characteristics of leaders and qualities of a good leader. In this video lecture, I'll be discussing with you three different types of leadership styles. Learning outcome of this video presentation are, after completion of this video presentation, you will be able to describe autocratic leadership style, then you will be able to describe democratic leadership style, and you will also be able to describe free reign leadership style. So sometimes we have seen that some leaders were considered as successful, and sometimes we also call that some leaders were effective. So what is the difference between this effectiveness and successful? The way through which a manager always tries to influence the behavior of the subordinates is known as leadership. In practical situation, the subordinate may come up to the expectations of the leader or not. If the leader succeeds in this, that means the behavior of the subordinate is compatible with the expectations of the leader. Then it may be due to two reasons. One is the impact of the leader is appropriate, and then another one is because of the position power of the leader. So as I have already stated, there are three different styles of leadership: those were autocratic, laissez-faire and democratic. So from this diagram you can see that autocratic leader, they just gives direction or instruction to their followers. On the other hand, in case of laissez-faire leader, they just makes their subordinate free to take their own decision. And in case of democratic leadership style, the decision making takes place in both ways. So let's discuss all this. So first let us discuss the autocratic leadership style. Under the autocratic leadership style, all decision making powers are centralized. That means the leader takes the decision and then he imposes that particular decision to his subordinates. This leadership style is usually used in the following conditions. The leader is running short of time, for example, the situation of danger and emergencies. When the leader needs to take decision very urgently, that time autocratic leadership style is occurred. Then the leader has all the information to solve the problem. In some cases, what we observe that the leader has all the detailed information regarding a situation. So then the leader can take decision immediately. The employees of the organization have full confidence on their leader. Moreover, they are all well motivated and believe that the leader has adopted the particular style of leadership, keeping the best interest of the teams in his mind. So in such cases, the autocratic style of leadership is occurred. Then when the leader requires a high level of productivity from an inexperienced team or individual. So suppose when the individuals were very new to the organization, then also the autocratic style of leadership occurs. The team may be placed at risk if it cannot finish the assigned task within the given time period. So basically, this autocratic style of leadership occurs whenever, in case of emergencies, or if it is time bound, or if the subordinates were not much experienced. In those cases, the autocratic type of leadership style emerges. Next, we will discuss about democratic leadership style. The democratic leadership style admires the decision-making process by a group of people. Here, a leader gives instruction after consulting the group. However, the final decision-making authority lies with the leader. The leader may adopt this style when the situation is unfavorable for a team. That means the team is unlikely to meet its goal and there is only a little ray of hope. In this case, the leader and subordinates can make a try to win the game with joint efforts. So in case of democratic style of leadership, both the leader and subordinates, they sit together and they decide for a solution for any kind of problem. Considering a situation where the manager has only a part and the employees have the other part of the information that is required to solve the task, then it is better to use this democratic style of leadership. This approach is most common when the leader is working with a new team or a team that is in a learning stage. Here the leader can win the cooperation of his group and can motivate them effectively and positively. So here, with the help of the subordinate, the leader takes the decision, and it's a win-win situation because the participation from both the leader and the subordinates were there. Then we will discuss about free-reign style of leadership. In this style, the leader does not lead, but leaves the group entirely to itself, and the leader acts as an coordinator. So this approach is most common with experienced team carrying out routine activities. Such leader allows maximum freedom by giving a free hand to its subordinates in deciding their own policies and methods. This style benefits the self-motivated team members looking for new responsibilities and challenges. Through this leadership style, a leader can assess the capability of his team members in performing their responsibilities. So when the subordinates were experienced enough and the work design is very much routine type, in that case, the leader does not impose any direction to them. Instead of that, he or she just let them to do their own work. So this is the kind of free-reign leadership style. Hope you have understood whatever we have discussed in this video lecture. See you again with another lecture. Thank you.